إن الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله تعالى فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله الله رحمة للعالمين، فشرح به الصدور وأنار به العقول وفتح به أعينا عميا وآذانا صما وقلوبا غلفا، صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه والتابعين لهم بإحسان وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد، فأوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل، فقد أمرنا الله تعالى بذلك في كتابه الكريم، فقال عز من قائل سبحانه: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. وقال تعالى: يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. ثم أما بعد، أصحاب السبت, the people of Saturday. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us the story of the people of Saturday in the Quran. They were a townsfolk, a group of people from Bani Israel, who had been commanded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to leave their worldly affairs on Saturdays. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because they were a people who used to fish and used the business of fishery to bring their livelihood, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tested them. So much so that on all the days of the week that they would fish, they would receive or they would catch nothing. And then on Saturdays, the day when they were to leave aside their business and their transaction, their worldly affairs, the fish would come in abundance. And this was the test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He mentions in the Quran subhanahu wa ta'ala. قَوْلُهُ وَاسْأَلْهُمْ عَنِ الْقَرْيَةِ الَّتِي كَانَتْ حَاضِرَةَ الْبَحْرِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and ask them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, about the town that was by the sea.
إِذْ يَعْدُونَ فِي السَّبْتِ إِذْ تَأْتِيهِمْ حِيتَانُهُمْ يَوْمَ سَبْتِهِمْ شُرَّعًا وَيَوْمَ لَا يَسْبِتُونَ لَا تَأْتِيهِمْ كَذَلِكَ نَبْلُوهُمْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَفْسُقُونَ.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when the fish used to come to them openly on the Sabbath day, on the Sabbath, on their Saturday, the fish used to come in abundance. And on all the other days of the week, the fish would not come. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كذلك, in such a way, نَبْلُوهُمْ بِمَا كَانُوا يَفْسُقُونَ. We tested them because they were always transgressing, always going beyond the boundaries of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And even in this, they transgressed the boundaries. For a group of them came, and they devised a plot or a scheme in order to catch the fish on Saturday, to bypass the commandment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so they said, we'll put our fishing nets out on Friday. We'll block the fish on Friday in the past. And then on Saturday the fish will be caught in the nets, but we won't pick them up on Saturday. We'll wait till Sunday when we pick them up. And in that way, we'll spend Saturday in ibadah and worship of Allah, and we'll get the fish on Sunday. Trying to trick Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they're only tricking themselves. When they did this, the townsfolk, and this is the important part, is that they divided into two groups about what was happening in these group of people. One of them began to command the good and forbid the evil. Al-amru bil-ma'ruf wal-nahi 'anil munkar. And the other group was one that said, leave them alone. Why are you wasting your time with them? That if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wishes to punish them, He'll punish them, but it's not our business. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues the verses in the Quran.
وَإِذْ قَالَتْ أُمَّةٌ مِّنْهُمْ لِمَ تَعِظُونَ قَوْمًا إِلَّهُ مُهْلِكُهُمْ لِمَ تَعِظُونَ قَوْمًا إِلَّهُ مُهْلِكُهُمْ أَوْ مُعَذِّبُهُمْ عَذَابًا شَدِيدًا.
They said, and when a community amongst them said, why do you preach? Why do you give da'wah? Why do you encourage a people whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to destroy anyway, or He's going to punish them with a severe torment. And then listen to those callers to good. They said,
قَالُوا مَعْذِرَةً إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ قَالُوا مَعْذِرَةً إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ وَلَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَّقُونَ.
They said in reply to those people that wanted to stop them from encouraging the good and forbidding evil, they said, مَعْذِرَةً إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ, as an excuse so that Allah will pardon us, so that Allah will forgive us and pardon us, your Lord. And they're saying, so that your Lord will forgive us, وَلَعَلَّهُمْ, and that perhaps, and Allah only knows whether they'll be guided or not, that perhaps they may fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and stop what they're doing. And only they were the ones that were saved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and everybody else was destroyed. Only those people that called to good and forbidden the evil were saved. And those people that saw the evil but were silent to it, they were like the people that committed the sin, because they were silent to it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said,
فَلَمَّا نَسُوا مَا ذُكِّرُوا بِهِ أَنْجَيْنَا الَّذِينَ يَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ السُّوءِ.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, so when they forgot the reminders that had been given to them, and they were reminded and they had revelation, when they forgot it, أَنْجَيْنَا الَّذِينَ يَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ السُّوءِ, that we saved those people who used to forbid the evil. When the punishment came down, those people who forbade the evil were the ones that were saved.
وَأَخَذْنَا الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا بِعَذَابٍ بَئِيسٍ بِمَا كَانُوا يَفْسُقُونَ.
And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, but we seized those who did wrong with a severe torment because of the way they used to rebel against Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's commandment and disobey Him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave the reason why He punished them.
فَلَمَّا عَتَوْا عَمَّا نُهُوا عَنْهُ قُلْنَا لَهُمْ كُونُوا قِرَدَةً خَاسِئِينَ.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, so when they exceeded the limits and they transgressed and went beyond the boundary, فَلَمَّا عَتَوْا عَمَّا نُهُوا عَنْهُ, from what they were prohibited, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قُلْنَا لَهُمْ, we said to them, كُونُوا قِرَدًا, be monkeys, خَاسِئِينَ, despised and rejected. And so in one sweeping night, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wiped away those people and transfigured them into monkeys and pigs. In one night. And the only the ones that were saved were those who used to forbid them and used to tell them that what they were doing is wrong. And so they came in the morning and they found the people in their village, they found monkeys and they found pigs. And they would go to them and they would talk to them, and that monkey and the pig would say that I'm such and such a person. And the pig would say that I'm such and such a person. A people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala transfigured for their disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Dear brothers and sisters, it's the nature of a human being to feel a desire and to feel an urge to do good, and to feel a desire or a drive to do bad. That's the nature of a human. Even if the person was secluded on an island by himself, he would still feel an urge that he should do some good, and he would still feel an urge to do some bad. And it's from this that the characteristic of the ummah is not only that we have this desire to do good, but it's incumbent upon us that we have to encourage other people to do good. And not only is it a characteristic that as an ummah we stay away from evil, but we also must, and it's incumbent upon us, to hold the hands of the people that do the evil, and to advise and admonish those people and hold them back from continuing in their sin and continuing in their evil that they are doing. And inshaAllah ta'ala, today we're going to be talking about this characteristic of the ummah, al-amru bil-ma'ruf wal-nahi 'anil munkar, which is commanding the good and forbidding the evil. If we had identification badges or identification cards and it had a description of who we were as a Muslim, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us what would be written in that. If that was a valid card and a person was a valid Muslim, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says what would be in the description. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says,
كُنْتُمْ خَيْرَ أُمَّةٍ أُخْرِجَتْ لِلنَّاسِ
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that you were the best ummah that was brought forth for the people.
تأمرون بالمعروف وتنهون عن المنكر وتؤمنون بالله.
And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes why they were the best nation, why this ummah was the best nation, because of their commanding and encouraging others to do good, and their commanding, their forbidding of doing evil and forbidding other people from doing the evil, and believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when it comes to this amru bil ma'ruf and nahi anil munkar, when it comes to good and bad, and encouraging others to one or the other, the people are in two groups. There are the people that command the good and forbid the evil. Command the good. When there's something good to be done, they encourage other people to do it. When there's something evil being done, they discourage people from doing it. These are the believing men and the believing women. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran,
وَالْمُؤْمِنُونَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتُ بَعْضُهُمْ أَوْلِيَاءُ بَعْضٍ.
And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes them.
يَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and the believing men and the believing women, that they are the awliya, the close and sincere friends of one another. يَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ, describing them that they command the good, encourage the good, وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ, and they forbid the evil. And then the second group, when it comes to the good and evil and the encouraging of it, the second group are those that when they see something evil, they encourage people to do the evil. And when they see something good, they try to discourage and push people away from that. And these are the munafiqun, the hypocrite men and the hypocrite women. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran,
المنافقون والمنافقات بعضهم من بعض يأمرون بالمنكر وينهون عن المعروف.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the hypocrite men and women are from one another. They enjoin on the people al-munkar, evil. They enjoin, they encourage people to do evil. يَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمُنْكَرِ وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمَعْرُوفِ, and they forbid people and discourage people from doing good things. And the Qur'an tells us that those who are successful, those who are attaining success, are those al-muflihun, are those people that command the good and forbid the evil. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions to us in the Quran, the verses come again and again, of people that set aside the commanding of the good and the forbidding of the evil. They would command people to do, they would say, ittaqillah, fear Allah, and then the next day they would sit with them and go to parties with them and be their friends, and as if nothing was happening, as if there was no sin taking place. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran,
لُعِنَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِن بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلَ عَلَى لِسَانِ دَاوُدَ وَعِيسَى ابْنِ مَرْيَمَ ذَلِكَ بِمَا عَصَوْا وَكَانُوا يَعْتَدُونَ كَانُوا لَا يَتَنَاهَوْنَ عَن مُنكَرٍ فَعَلُوهُ لَبِئْسَ مَا كَانُوا يَفْعَلُونَ.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, لُعِنَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا, that cursed are those people who disbelieved, مِن بَنِي إِسْرَائِيل, from the children of Israel, عَلَى لِسَانِ دَاوُودِ, on the tongue of Dawood. And you'll see them that they keep saying that we're the children of Dawood, are the children of Dawood. Indeed, when they transgressed, it was Dawood alayhi salam that cursed them. عَلَى لِسَانِ دَاوُودَ وَعِيسَى ابْنِ مَرْيَمَ, and the tongue of Isa ibn Maryam عَلَيْهِمُ السَّلَامِ ذَلِكَ بِمَا عَصَوْا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always says why they were cursed. ذَلِكَ بِمَا عَصَوْا, this is because of their disobedience, and their disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَكَانُوا يَعْتَدُونَ, and they used to transgress. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, what was that transgression? What was that disobedience? كَانُوا لَا يَتَنَاهَوْنَ عَنْ مُنْكَرٍ فَحَدُ, that they would never discourage a person. They would never forbid someone in their community from the evil that they were doing. This is why they were cursed. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in a hadith teaching us also that when we do not command the good and not forbid the evil, we turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when the hard times come upon us. And by leaving al-amru bil ma'ruf wa nahy 'anil munkar, the hard times will come upon us. And it's that moment that the Prophet ﷺ knows that the ummah will turn back and making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the moment when the dua will not be accepted. The Prophet ﷺ said, لَتَأْمُرُنَّ بِالْمَعْرُ, that you are going to, and you will, and you have to command the good. وَلَتَنْهَوُنَّ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ, and that you will and you have to forbid the evil. أَوْ لَيَبْعَثَنَّ اللَّهُ عَلَيْكُمْ عِقَابًا مِنْهُ, or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send down a punishment upon you. ثُمَّ تَدْعُونَهُ فَلَا يُسْتَجَابُ لَكُمْ, then at that moment you're going to turn in dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and your dua will not be answered. And in another riwayah, in another narration, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَوْ يَلْعَنُكُمْ كَمَا لَعَنَكُمْ, or he will curse you